Just a week away, so we're looking at some spooky experiments to get your kids ready.
Mr. Science Jason Lindsey joins us. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you two?
We're good. Doing great. So, all right, so your first one, a dissolving witch.
Yeah, what I have here is a witch's hat on some decoration. It's a decoration hat, of course. And I have it on some styrofoam cups. You'll see those here. And here I have some witch's drool. Have you ever found some witch's drool around your house?
Yes.
Yeah. So what I'm going to do is place these cups inside of here, and they're going to quickly dissolve all the cups of this right here, the drool from the witch. Watch this. As I push this in here, you will notice how it all starts to go away. What's happening, which dissolves, is the styrofoam cup is being taken apart by the smaller pieces. Now, what is in the container? It's just something you put on your fingernails. It's called acetone, and it takes apart styrofoam cups. Now, styrofoam cups are very bad for the environment. One styrofoam cup, it takes about 500 years to dissolve or to break down in the environment. So try not to use these, but you'll notice how, kind of gross.
Look at that. All right, next you have Frankenstein's hand.
Yeah, it's going to come alive. I have a glove that you might use as a medical bill. You can get it at your local department store. And then I have a cup that has vinegar on the inside. This here, inside of here, is some baking soda. I'm going to mix the two together, and we're going to try to make Frankenstein's hand come alive. We'll dump all the ingredients in. A chemical reaction is happening. Okay, so
that's great.
Yeah,
all right.
We got a mess there, didn't we? Chemical reaction happened inside, Larry Robin, and that created a gas that made Frankenstein's hand come alive.
Gotcha. All right, bleeding paper.
Do you have paper that bleeds there at work? You know, used to be print out your scripts. Did your scripts ever bleed?
No, but I'm interested to see how it can work.
So I have something over here called goldenrod paper. Goldenrod paper is goldenrod, as you can see the color, but it's also known as a pH paper, meaning that if I smack it and it turns red, it will indicate that whatever I put on that paper is a base. If it stays this color right here, it is an acid. So in here, mystery matter, well, not so mystery, you get it from your kitchen, it's water and baking soda. So I'm going to put my hand in here just like this, mix it around. Keep mixing it around, and I'm going to smack it on the paper. 2, 1, lift out, and the paper.
Oh, yeah.
What do you know? Science.
We indicated that the baking soda and water was a base. That's it.
Got it.
I love it. Well, for more simple tricks like that with your kids, Jason Lindsey is on social media. You can find him there. He's also at hookedonscience.org. Thanks, Jason.
Thanks, Jason.
Thank you. Keep safe. Keep well.